All right, a few more speakers and some more songs, and then we're going to have a little open session. Marvin Cohen, please.
I know him from parties. I used him in the beginning when he didn't know me too much. He was very generous in telling me about parties. But then I got to know, because it snowballs, it gets compounded. So the more parties you go to, you more connections and all like that, and you hear about more. Anyway, I contributed to his sex life. I introduced him to women, mainly from parties. A few of them were wealthy. But it didn't mean that much to him, maybe. But I wasn't a pimp or anything, because I didn't get anything out of it. except maybe I got a little gratitude. Anyway, he was very graceful in his social life. He went around to parties as if he was going around and being in solitude. By the way, the people who spoke before already gave the essence of him. I was going to say about that he got shot in St. Lo in the back. A few other things pointed out about him. He really loved people, and people couldn't help but respond. One thing about him, he had a great acoustical part of his brain, kind of like a genius. He would hear a song, and then he could sing it. And it seemed to be pitch perfect, whatever that means. So especially Gilbert and Sullivan.
Yeah.
I could mention anything out of Gilbert and Sullivan and he'd sing it. But sometimes he only heard it once or twice. And that also folk songs from different countries, like Wales too. Another thing that brought us together in common was that we both hated religion. I'm sorry he's not here to still hate religion. One final memory I have, when he had a heart attack and then he recuperated a bit, and the doctor said, don't carry too many pounds of groceries. So I used to go grocery shopping with him. And during one excursion, we were coming back, and my arms were laden with heavy vegetables and other groceries. And then he and I were talking, and we concocted a compound multiple brilliant ultra clever pun. And it was so lovely. It was so natural. It was so simple. It could easily be remembered. Since my arms were laden, I didn't even have to bother to pick a paper and a pen from my pocket and write it down, because we both were beaming with the pride of collaborative creativity on this lovely, lovely pun that was so obvious that it would resound in our future conversations. Then you guessed it. It was immediately forgotten. One of the creators of that poem will never be forgotten by people who are here.